Good day, everyone. I am Sir Jerickson Chua, and welcome to Animation One.
Okay, so let's proceed on the different binary numbers. So, in the binary numbers, we follow the basic unit of measurement, which is your bits. It's ones and zeros. So, later on our presentation, you will understand how we compute using these values, how we add, multiply, divide, and convert from decimal to binary unit values. Now let's proceed to the binary number system. The word binary comes from bi, meaning two. We see bi words such as bicycle with two wheels and binocular with two eyes. When you say binary number, this is pronounced with each digit. Example, the binary number 101 or sometimes 101. This way, people don't confuse with the decimal number. A single binary digit like 0 or 1 is called a bit. For example, 11010 is 5 bits long. The word bit is made up of words from binary digit. That's why it's called a bit. A binary number is made up of zeros and ones. 110100 is an example of a binary number. There is no 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 in binary. Now, how do we count using binary? We always start with 0, then 1. But there is no symbol for 2. What do we do now? So let's take a look at this table. Here are some equivalent values for binary numbers and the decimal number. 0 is represented with 0. 1 is represented by 1. 2 is represented by 10. 3 is 11. 4 is 100. 5 is 101. 6 is 110. 7 is 111. 8 is 1000. 9 is 1001. 10 is 1010. 11 is 1011. 12 is 1100. 13 is 1101. 14 is 1110, and 15 is 1111. So that is the difference between the decimal and the binary number. So how do we convert decimal numbers to binary conversion? The process is a successive division. You need to divide the decimal number by 2. Why 2? Because as we said a while ago, binary numbers has only two values, which is your 0 and 1. The remainder of your least significant bit of binary number. If the quotation is 0, the conversion is complete. Else, repeat this step using a quotation as decimal number. The new remainder is the next most significant bit of the number system. Example, let's try to convert the decimal number 6. So, when placing a decimal number, you need to have a subscript of 10 because that is a representation of a decimal number. We're going to convert it into a binary number. So what you're going to do now is we're going to divide it by 2. So 2 divided by 6 is 3, remainder 0. 2 divided by 3 is 1, remainder 1. 2 divided by 1 is 0, remainder 1. So how do we do now writing the binary number? So you just need to put the most significant bit to the least significant bit. So you're going to write 110. So 6 is equal to 110. So that's how you convert the number. Next, let's try to convert this. We're going to convert decimal number 26 into its equivalent binary number. So, 2 divided by 26 is 13, remainder 0. 2 divided by 13 is 6, remainder 1. 2 divided by 6 is 3, remainder 0. 2 divided by 3 is 1, remainder 1. 2 divided by 1 is 0, remainder 1. So, we have here the most significant bit and the least significant bit. Then we're going to write it. It's 11010. So that's 11010 base of 2. So 26 in decimal is equal to 11010 in binary. Next, let's convert 41 into its binary equivalent. To divide by 41 is 20, remainder 1. To divide by 20 is 10, remainder 0. To divide by 10 is 5, remainder 0. To divide by 5 is 2, remainder 1. To divide by 2 is 1, remainder 0. And to divide by 1 is 0, remainder 1. So most significant bit to the least significant bit, that's 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. So that's how you convert 41 decimal into a binary number. Try to do this example and you should have an answer just like this one. 13 is 1101, 22 is 10110, 43 is 101011, and 158 is 10011110. So you need to try this on your own so that you can understand how to do decimal to binary. Let's proceed on how to convert binary to decimal process. So the process is weighted multiplication. Multiply each of the binary number by its corresponding bit weight factor. So bit 0 is 2 raised to 0 is equal to 1. 2 raised to 1 is equal to 2. 2 raised to 2 is equal to 4 and other. Sum up all the products in steps to get the decimal number. Convert the decimal number 0110 into its decimal equivalent. So we're going to convert this binary number into decimal equivalent. So what I want you to do now is place your decimal numbers 0, 1, 1, 0. Then you need to create the corresponding bit weighting factor. So 2, 2, 2, 2 raised to 0, raised to 1, raised to 2, and raised to 3. So when you multiply this, 2 raised to 0 is equal to 1. As we say in the math, any number that is raised to 0 is equal to 1. Then 2 raised to 1 is 2. 2 raised to 2, that's 2 times 2 is 4. 2 raised to 3 is 2 times 2 times 2, that's 8. So we have here 2 and 4. You need to eradicate 8 because it has a 0 bit. And 1 has a 0 bit, so eradicate that. So you just need to add 4 and 2, that will be 6 as decimal number. Let's try another example. We're going to compute 10010 into its decimal equivalent. So we have here 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1, 2 raised to 2, 2 raised to 3, 2 raised to 4. That's 1, 2, 8, I 1. That's 1, 2, 4, 8, 16. And we're going to add only the values that has 1 as their bit. So we have 2 plus 16. So 18 will be the result of this binary number. Next, let's try to convert this. We have 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. So 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1, 2 raised to 2, 2 raised to 3, 2 raised to 4, 2 raised to 5, 2 raised to 6. That's 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64. So we just need to add 32, 16, 4, and 1. The result will be 53. So that is your decimal equivalent. Try to convert these numbers on your paper. And the result should be just like this one. So 0110 is 6, 11010 is 26, 0110101 53, 11010011 is 211. So that's how you convert binary to decimal number. Okay, let's try to convert this binary number into a decimal number. So we have 1101.101. So 1101 is equal to 13 because we don't need to add this number anymore, the zero. So for this one, we have 1/2, 1/4, 1/8, 1/16, 1/32, 1/64, and so on. So let's try to compute 1 divided by 2, or 1/2 is equal to 0.5. Next is 1 divided by 8, that's 0.125. We're going to add 0.5 here and the result will be 0.625. So we have 13.325. Numbers can be placed from left to right or the point to show values greater than 1 and less than 1. Okay, so yan. So 10 means 2 in decimal, 0.1 means half. So 10.1 in binary is 2.5 in decimal. Okay, so to show that the number is binary number format, follow it with a little 2 like 101 base of 2. This way, people won't think that this is a 101. Okay, so that's how you do binary to decimal. Let's proceed to binary addition, subtraction, and multiplication. So the first one is addition. So how do we add binary numbers? For example, we have 1101 plus 111. So we're going to add this binary number, and then we're going to add first 1 and 1. So in our binary numbers, 1 is equal to 1 in decimal. 10 is equal to 2 in decimal. So 1 and 1 is equal to 2. So the result will be 0 raised to 1. Because 1 and 1 is equal to 2. Next, 1 and 1 is 2 also. So 0 raised to 1. And then 1, 1, and 1. So 1, 1, and 1 is equal to 3, right? So in binary numbers, 3 is 1 and 1. So 1, 1, 1 is 1 and 1. 1 and 1 is 1, 0. So let's try to compute if it's correct. So 1, 1, 0, 1 is equal to 1, 2, 4, and 8. So that's 8 plus 4 is 12 plus 1. This is equal to 13. Okay, so let's erase this. Next, 1, 1, 1. So 1, 1, 1 is 1, 2, and 4. So 4, 2, 1 is equal to 7. So that's 7. So the result should be 20. Okay, so let's see if we got 20. 1, 0, 1, 0, 0. So this is 1, 2, 4, 8, and 16. The only value that we have here that has 1 is 16 and 4. So disregard this, disregard this, and disregard this. So the result will be 20. So that is your decimal number. So we have here 20 as your value for adding the number. So that's how you do addition of a number. Okay, let's proceed to the subtraction of binary numbers. Let's try to have this example. 1, 0, 1, 1, minus 1, 0, 1. So 1 minus 1 is 0. 1 minus 0, bring down 1. Next, 0 minus 1 cannot be. So we need to borrow a value here to place a value at 0. So you need to cross out that 1 and 1, 0. And 1, 0 is equals to 2 in decimal. So 1, 0 minus 1 or 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. So the result, the 1 value here will turn into 0. Okay. So let's try to convert this into decimal numbers so that you can see the difference between the two. Okay, if we're correct. So 1011 is 1, 2, 4, and 8. So that will be, erase this, 8 plus 2 is 11. Next, 101 is 1, 2, and 4. Erase this one. This will be equal to 4 plus 1 is 5. So 11 minus 5 should be 6. Okay. So let's try to see if our result is 6 and if I'm correct. So 1, 1, 0 is 1, 2, and 4. Eradicate this one. 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. So that's 6. So that's how you subtract binary number. Let's try to have another example. Let's just remove this and okay. 1, 1, 0, 1, 1 minus 1, 1. Okay, let's convert this first so that you can see the value. Let's just move it here. Let's convert that first. 1, 1, 0, 1, 1 is 1, 2, 4, 8, and 16. Remove this. 16 plus 8 is 24. Plus 2 is 26, plus 1 is 27. So this is 27 minus the value of 1, 1, 1 is 1, 1, 1 is 1, 2, and 4. This is 4, 6, that is 7. 7. So this is 7. So we need to get the remainder. We need to get the result of 27 minus 7. So, let's subtract. 1 minus 1 is 0. 1 minus 1 is 0. 0 minus 1 is cannot be. So, this will be removed. And this will be 1, 0. So, 1, 0 is 2 in decimal. So, that will be 2 minus 1 is 1. Now, here we have a value of 0, so you just need to bring down 0 here and bring down 1. So 1, 0, 1, 0, 0. This is 1, 2, 4, 8, and 16. So we just need to get the value of 16 plus 4, that will be 20. So that's how you get your values when subtracting binary numbers. Okay, next, let's proceed to the multiplication of binary numbers. So let's try to multiply 1 and 1 multiplied by 1 and 0. So we just need to multiply first here going there. So we have 0 times 1 is 0, right? 0 times 1 is 0. 1 times 1 is 1. 1 times 1 is 1. So we have 0, 1, and 1. So let's try to check if they're correct. 1, 1 is 3. 1, 0 is 2. So that will be, the result should be 6. So 1, 3 times 2 is 6, right? So 1, 1, 0, if we're going to convert this into decimal, is 1. 2 and 4. So eradicate this. 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. So that's how you multiply binary number. Another example. Okay, let's have a bigger number such as 1, 1, 0, 1 multiplied by 1, 1, 0. Okay, let's see. 1, 1, 0, 1 is 1, 2, 4, and 8. So 8 plus 4 is 12 plus 1. This is 13. Multiplied by 1, 1, 0 is 1, 2, and 4. So 4 plus 2 is 6. So 13 times 6. So when we're going to multiply 13 times 6, that's 78. So the result should be 78. So that's your number. Okay, so let's write the multiply. So 0 times 1, that's 0, 0, 0, and 0. Because 0 times 1, 0, 0 times 0, 0 times 1, 0 times 1. Next, we have 1, 0, 1, 1. Next is we have 1, 0, 1, 1. Okay, let's add values. Okay, so we have 0, 0 plus 1 is 1. 1, 0, 0 is 1. This is 1 also. 1 plus 1 is equal to 1, 0. 1 plus 1 is equal to 1, 0. Okay, let's see if we got 78. So 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0. Okay, this is 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, and 64. Oh, 64. Okay, let's remove this. 64. So let's see. We're going to remove 32, 16, and 1. So we are left with 2, 4, 8, and 64. So we're going to add 64 plus 8 plus 4 plus 2. So the result is 78. So we got the correct answer. So that's how you multiply your binary numbers. So that's how simple it is. So I hope that you have learned how to multiply, add, and subtract binary numbers. It's very simple. You just need to convert it into decimal numbers so that you can see if your answer is correct.
Thank you for watching, and I hope that you have learned many things from our discussion. See you on our next lesson. Keep safe and God bless.